What is up, guys? Action Figure Jump Squad here, and today we stopped by Forbidden Planet and picked up some Marvel Legends, and one of them is Deathlock from the Sasquatch Wave. So, let's get right into the review. So, we have a nice Deadpool logo right there. It says Deathlock. We have, like, the little Deadpool insignia thing right there. We have, let me see if I can get that frame. We have a nice picture of Deathlock there. Not in full color, like usual. With the rest of the figures in the wave right there. We have a read-up right here. A nice product shot. Nothing at the bottom. So, let's crack this thing open. Alrighty, so we have Deathlock out of the box right now. And I put him in a pretty cool pose. Here, let me just get that in the shot. Alright, so first, he comes with the left arm to the Sasquatch Build-A-Figure. Not too sure if I'll build this figure yet, but I have other things that I want to build first, like Lizard, so we'll see. He does seem like a good figure, though, so I might do it. Second, I found out they can plug in one of those little booster effects. Oops. And it's not a tight fit. They're not supposed to go in there, but you can kind of just jam one onto it. Yeah, I think it's pretty cool. This chain on the minigun is removable. He also comes with this pistol right here. It's got like a scope, extended mag, and everything, so that's pretty dope. I like that. And of course, he comes with this giant minigun. I'll just go over it for a little bit. It looks really cool. It is the slot where you can put the bullets, and that's where the shells eject. The barrels do spin. I think that's a pretty cool feature. So, like, if you like to do stop motions or anything, I think that's cool. It's a hollow gun, very lightweight. That's pretty good. This backpack is removable. However, I don't really like the way he looks without it. I just feel like the shoulder pads make him look cooler. So, I'd keep that on. But it is removable, so if you want to do, like, if you want to put that on someone else, you know, it's good. Except for, like, all his accessories and stuff. Well, actually, this pipe can come out. Not too sure why, but I guess it can. So, I guess that's cool. Alright, so, let's get into his articulation. So, first, he has some head pivot. Some head rotation. He can look up that far. Look down that far. His shoulders have a hinge. Rotation. His double jointed elbows. On this hand, he has a hinge that goes down and up. And on this hand, he has a hinge that goes in and out. So that's pretty cool. His ab crunch that goes that far forward. And not very far back. Yeah, it only has one click forward, no clicks back. His waist rotation can kick out that far. Kick back about that far. His upper thigh cut, double joint knees, a calf cut right there, ankle hinge, and ankle pivot. So, now, I thought I'd just go over some details that I think were really cool in this figure. Number one, I think the skin looks so good. Like, it looks kind of like zombified, like kind of how he's supposed to look. It looks very cool. Like, I like that a lot. I also like the paints that they use. Like, I just feel like they're very gentle. They're not like super flashy or anything, so they don't like pop out too much. And then the silver looks nice. It's pretty basic. Yeah, and this figure is just very well structured. Like, I love all the weapons he comes with, and the color for these is pretty good. It's a nice glossy dark silver, like a gunmetal silver. It's pretty nice. I like it. Yeah, all the guns look really nice. The American flag came out pretty good. I mean, they probably used a print or something like that, but that's fine. There's a little bit of a splotchiness on the neck. I don't know if that's supposed to be there, but it's kind of like silver has like splotchiness with like a brown mixture. I don't know. Maybe it's supposed to be like that, but maybe it's not. So, yeah. Alright, so let's get into some size comparisons. Alright, so now I have Deathlock in between the Infinity War Iron Man and the Juggernaut Wave Cable. I just thought that these figures kind of showed pretty good scale, because the Iron Man is about 6 inches tall. Deathlock is a little bit taller, so that's probably like, I don't know the exact measurements, because I don't care. Then Cable, I think I measured him out to be 7 inches, so he's under 7 and over 6, you know, that's all I need to say, really. But, yeah, that just gives you some perspective.